Swami Vivekanand and Ramakrishna Paramahansa, being a guru and a shishya, was not so easy. In fact, Swami Vivekananda wanted so much so to become Ramakrishna Paramahansa ji's shishya that he went through lot of exercises. Few exercises which are not palatable, but as a shishya, it is must for all of us to know. And what Swami Vivekananda ji saw in Ramakrishna Paramahansa ji was very inevitable through the eyes of Swami Vivekananda ji, which others would only understand now by knowing them. One such rare conversation between Ramakrishna ji and Swami ji is what I am going to narrate to you all. This, I very strongly feel, should be passed to the next generation, and hence my attempt to cover this in my video. Let's understand both. Swami Vivekananda, I can't find free time. Life has become hectic. Ramakrishna Paramahansa ji replies, activity gets you busy, but productivity gets you free. Swami Vivekananda has a second question to ask. Why has life become complicated now? Ramakrishna ji replies, stop analyzing life. It makes it complicated. Just live it. Swami ji has a third question. Why are we then constantly unhappy? Ramakrishna ji's reply, worrying has become your habit. That's why you are not happy. Swami ji's fourth question. Why do good people always suffer? Answer, diamond cannot be polished without friction. Gold cannot be purified without fire. Good people go through trials but don't suffer. With that experience, their life becomes better, not bitter. Next question, number 5. From Swamiji, you mean to say such experience is useful? Reply comes from Paramahansa ji, yes, in every term. Experience is a hard teacher. It gives the test first and the lessons later. It gets serious and pops up to another question. Swamiji, because of so many problems, we don't know where we are heading. Reply comes pat from Paramahansa ji. If you look outside, you will not know where you are heading. Look inside. Eyes provide sight. Heart provides the way. Seventh question from Swami ji. Does failure hurt more than moving in the right direction? Ramakrishna ji's reply to this difficult question is, success is a measure as decided by others. Satisfaction is a measure as decided by you. Question number 8 by Swami ji. In tough times, how do you stay motivated? Ramakrishna ji's reply to this question, which many would also look at as a relief, as an answer. And the answer is, always look at how far you have come rather than how far you have to go. Always count your blessings, not what you are missing. Number 9 from Swami ji. What surprises you about people, Guruji? And the Guru replies, when they suffer, they ask, why me? When they prosper, they never ask, why me? Number 10 from Swamiji. How can I get the best out of life? Isn't it so true a concern for all of us? And here comes Ramkrishnaji's reply. Face your past without regret. Handle your present with confidence. Prepare for the future without fear. Number 11. Swami Vivekananda asks one last question. Guruji, sometimes I feel my prayers are not answered. Now this gets Ramkrishnaji little serious. He lowers his note and tone and replies, there are no unanswered prayers. Keep the faith and drop the fear. Life is a mystery to solve, not a problem to resolve. Trust me, life is wonderful if you know how to live. Now, these many questions and answers are so much so true in terms of understanding life. Everybody who is listening to the question and answer would some or the other time correlate with the problems or the question they themselves want to ask and get answers from. I am very sure that these questions sometimes that you have asked to yourself and would have not settled with the momentary answers. The entire purpose of life is to live it consciously. If you are aware and if you are conscious, I think life will become easy to live. With that food for thought, I leave you all at this. Thank you.